हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर डिस्कस विद द टॉपिक ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ कंपोजिट इंसुलेशन, व्हाट इज मीन बाय कंपोजिट इंसुलेशन एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दैट कंपोजिट इंसुलेशन। सो टुडे वी आर सीइंग द टॉपिक ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ कंपोजिट इंसुलेशन। फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कंपोजिट इंसुलेशन। The composite insulation can be occur in two ways. It is in long term and it is in short term breakdown. We know what is the breakdown phenomena, that when the ionization or the collision of an atom will occur, the breakdown will occur. It is occur in various medium, in gaseous, in liquid and in solid medium. So how it will be occur and what is the breakdown of composite insulation? So that we have seen in this topic. So let us start. What is the mechanism? So as mentioned in earlier section, if dielectric losses are low, the cumulative heat produced will be low and thermal breakdown will not occur. So to occurrence of that particular thermal breakdown, the dielectric losses are low and cumulative heat means the total heat produced in that particular section will be low. So however, several other factors can cause short term and long term breakdown. So composite insulation, breakdown of composite insulation will occur in two ways. So first we have seen what is mean by short term breakdown. So in this short term breakdown, if the electric field stresses are very high and failure may occur in seconds or even faster without any substantial damage to the insulating surface prior to breakdown. Means when the electric field stress on a particular medium is very high, then that breakdown will occur in shorter term duration. So that kind of breakdown is known as short term breakdown. Second thing, it has been observed that breakdown results from one or more discharges when the applied voltage is close to observed breakdown value. Means when more than number of breakdown will occur in the system, so it has been observed that the breakdown results from one or more discharges when the applied voltage is close to observed breakdown value. Means that applied voltage in the whole system will be a close value to that observed value. So that time that particular short term breakdown occur. There exists a critical stress in the volume of dielectric at which discharges of given magnitude can enter the insulation from surface and propagate rapidly into its volume to cause breakdown. Means when that such kind of breakdown will occur, a critical stress in the volume of dielectric at which discharges of given magnitude, means the magnitude of that particular discharges or that particular molecule or in the system will be the same and it will propagate in the same direction or it will rapidly propagate it. So experiments with single discharges on an insulating material have shown that breakdown occurs more rapidly when the electric field in the insulation is such that it assists the charge particles in the discharge to penetrate into insulation than when the field opposes their entry. So breakdown was observed to occur more radially when the bombarding particles are electrons rather than positive ions. So hence we see when we are using electrons for the bombarding or for the collision process, so as compared with the positive ions means proton, so that kind of electron gives more breakdown. So in addition, there are local field intensification due to the presence of impurities and variations in the thickness of solid insulation, and these local field intensifications play a very important role in causing breakdown under high field conditions. The actual effect being dependent on the field in the insulation before the discharge impinge on it. Means as the thickness of that particular medium is more, then the breakdown causes, the causes behind the breakdown or the time duration of the breakdown will be more. More in the sense the collision process occur fast. So thickness also measures or also matters that particular breakdown strength. So hence, short-term breakdown means the breakdown which will occur in short time. Now we will see what is mean by long-term breakdown. So in long-term breakdown is also called as aging of insulation. Aging of insulation means what? As insulations are new, they are provided a particular insulating age. Means as the insulation goes on old, there will be a damaging of insulation. So that damaging of insulation is also known as long term breakdown. So hence in long term breakdown, what happens? The principal effect responsible for the aging of insulation, which eventually leads to breakdown, arise from the thermal process and partial discharges. Means the breakdown arise from thermal process. What is mean by thermal process? Means that particular insulations are in the open or in the open in the air. So external atmospheric air or heat in the atmosphere will aging the insulation, and that causes the aging of that particular insulation, means that causes the thermal breakdown. Partial discharges normally occur within the volume of composite insulation system. So partial discharges are not occur outsider, it is in the insulation. So in addition, the charge accumulation and conduction on the surface of the insulation also contributes significantly towards the aging of failure of insulation. So aging and breakdown due to partial discharges, how it is occur? During the manufacture of composite insulation, gas filled cavities will be present within the dielectric or adjacent to the interface between conductor and the dielectric. Means insulation will be wrapped on particular conductor, whether it is metal, non-metal, whatever it is. So when that gas cavities at the time of manufacturing, either it is in the conductor or it is in that particular insulating material, so that kind of cavities are present in that material, so that causes the partial discharges. When a voltage is applied to such a system, discharges occur within the gas filled cavities. Means that discharges that occupies that particular cavity, and that will cause to what? That will cause to partial discharge of that particular material. These discharges are called partial discharges and involve the transfer of electric charge between the two points in sufficient quantity to cause the discharge of the local capacitance. So some kind of capacitance also present when this conductor are charged. Okay, at a given voltage, the impact of this charge on the dielectric surface produces a deterioration of the insulating properties. Means that particular deterioration will occur if excess voltage are provided to that particular material. In many ways, depending on the geometry of the cavity and the nature of dielectric. So that particular geometry means the space which was occupied by the cavity also depend on a breakdown, means also effect to the breakdown. The study of breakdown by partial discharges is very important in industrial system. And for what reason it is important? Because in industrial system, much more applications or much more things are manufactured. And when that contain a cavity, a partial discharges will occur, and that causes to the breakdown of insulating material. So to improve the insulation property of the material, that care must be taken to reduce that particular cavity in the partial discharges. The degree of aging depends on the discharge inception voltage, VI. Inception voltage means the voltage at which discharge occur. Second thing, and the discharge magnitude. इट हैज बीन शोन दैट वी आई इज स्ट्रांगली डिपेंड ऑन द परमिटिविटी ऑफ द डायलेक्ट्रिक एक्सप्लानर एंड द थिकनेस ऑफ द कैविटी जी. सो दैट इंसेप्शन वोल्टेज डिपेंड ऑन टू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट थिंग इज वॉट, दैट इज द परमिटिविटी ऑफ द डायलेक्ट्रिक एंड सेकेंड थिंग इज थिकनेस ऑफ द कैविटी जी. सो इंसेप्शन वोल्टेज फ्रॉम दैट वी आर गेटिंग वी आई इज इक्वल टू ई जी अपॉन एक्सप्लॉन आर इन टू टी प्लस एक्सप्लॉन आर जी. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर फोटो गेटिंग इंसेप्शन वोल्टेज, वेयर ई जी इज द ब्रेकडाउन स्ट्रेस ऑफ द कैविटी एयर गैप ऑफ थिकनेस जी एंड टी इज द थिकनेस ऑफ डायलेक्ट्रिक इन सीरीज विथ कैविटी. फॉर एनी गिवन अरेंजमेंट जी प्लस वन विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट, लेट अस कॉल दिस कॉन्स्टेंट एज सी. Then above equation can be written as, so for reducing that equation added g plus 1, so it becomes vi is equal to eg upon epsilon r into epsilon r minus 1 into g plus c. So differentiating on both side, we are getting this equation, that is dvi upon dg is equal to epsilon r minus 1 upon epsilon r into eg plus g plus c upon epsilon r minus 1 into dE upon dG. Here eg is always positive and dE upon dG is always negative or zero to get that particular magnitude of a inception voltage VI. In obtaining the above expression, two assumptions have been made. One is that in the cavity stress eg is equal to epsilon r is equal into E, where E is the electric field across the dielectric, and second assumption is that within the cavity Eg max upon Eg is equal to 1. When these assumptions are valid, the Paschen law can be used to explain the breakdown of the gas gap. However, the validity of above assumptions depend upon the shape and dimension of the cavity. So again, the points come on the shape and the cavity geometry. So that kind of assumptions are for the determination of inception voltage. And once we are getting the inception voltage, once we are getting the magnitude of that particular inception voltage, so we are calculating the partial discharges. So when calculating the partial discharges, that will link to the manufacturing process of insulating material. So from that long-term breakdown, short-term breakdown, we are getting some kind of conclusion that are made. And what are that conclusion? The first one is that for very small cavities, VI means inception voltage decreases as the cavity depth increases following the Paschen curve of the gas breakdown. This is the first assumption or the first conclusion. Second one, in spite of erosion in the cavity walls, breakdown will not occur and the life of insulation is very long if applied voltage is less than 2 VI. Means the inception voltage into 2 means double the inception voltage. When we are applying the voltage, that will be less than the double the inception voltage. So insulating property of that particular material will be high. This is the second assumption. Third assumption is that for applied voltages greater than 2 VI, erosion is faster and therefore aging of insulation is quicker. That is the vice versa condition to the second conclusion. And last one, that is fourth one, the total capacitance of the cavity is not discharged as a single event but as a result of many discharges, each discharge involving only a small area of the cavity wall determined by the conductivity of the cavity surface in the region of discharge. Means the discharge will occur in the cavity when much more discharges are occurring in that particular cavity. So total discharge will depend upon the number of collisions. This is the last assumptions. Up to this, we are seeing short-term breakdown, long-term breakdown, that is composite breakdown of composite insulation. Now we will see what is the application of that insulating material. So the main requirements of insulating material used for power apparatus are, that is, that are high insulating resistance. It must carry the insulating resistance. Second thing is, it should have high dielectric strength. थर्ड वन इज गुड मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, दैट इज डेंसिटी, इलास्टिसिटी. फोर्थ वन, इट शुड नॉट बी अफेक्टेड बाय केमिकल्स अराउंड इट. लास्ट वन, इट शुड बी नॉन हाइग्रोस्कोपिक बिकॉज द डायलेक्ट्रिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ एनी मटेरियल गोज वेरी मच डाउन विद मॉइस्चर कंट्रोल. सो दैट आर द सम प्रॉपर्टीज दैट मस्ट हैव फॉर द इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल. एंड वॉट इज द एप्लीकेशन दैट इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल आर यूजिंग इन केबल्स इन एवरीवेयर वेयर वी कैन नॉट गेट द शॉक और वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सेफ्टी फॉर द पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटीज. सो देयर वी आर यूजिंग इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल. एंड द फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन इज दैट एप्लीकेशन इन पावर ट्रांसफॉर्मर. इन पावर ट्रांसफॉर्मर द वोल्टेज लेवल इज टू मच हाई. इट इज इन द रेंज ऑफ थाउजेंड्स ऑफ केवी. सो टू प्रोवाइड वन द सेफ्टी, ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स आर द फर्स्ट टू इनकाउंटर लाइटनिंग एंड अदर हाई वोल्टेज सर्जेस. द ट्रांसफॉर्मर इंसुलेशन हैज टू विस्टैंड वेरी हाई इम्पल्स वोल्टेज मेनी टाइम्स द पावर फ्रिक्वेंसी ऑपरेटिंग वोल्टेज. मीन्स इफ द ऑपरेटिंग वोल्टेज इज वी आई और ऑपरेटिंग वोल्टेज इज वी, देन द इंसुलेशन मस्ट प्रोवाइड टू द टू इंटू वी, मीन्स डबल ऑफ दैट इंसुलेशन, डबल ऑफ दैट पर्टिक्युलर वोल्टेज. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशन. द ट्रांसफॉर्मर इंसुलेशन इज ब्रॉडली डिवाइडेड इंटू कंडक्टर टू टर्न इंसुलेशन, देन कॉइल टू कॉइल इंसुलेशन एच वी कॉइल एंड एल वी कॉइल, देन लो वोल्टेज कॉइल टू अर्थ इंसुलेशन, देन हाई वोल्टेज कॉइल टू लो वोल्टेज कॉइल इंसुलेशन एंड हाई वोल्टेज कॉइल टू ग्राउंड इंसुलेशन. मीन्स देर विल बी टोटल फाइव काइंड ऑफ इंसुलेशन वी आर अप्लाइंग इन द पावर ट्रांसफॉर्मर. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल और एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दैट इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल. थैंक यू.